Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Dr. Shemmassian, and I've been helping students get into med schools like Stanford, Northwestern, and UCLA for over 15 years. Today we're going to be talking about the ideal medical school application timeline. I'll tell you exactly what you need to do each period of your application year so you can submit great materials early and maximize your odds of getting into med school. As a pre-med student, you hear advice on everything from the courses you should take to how to prepare for the MCAT. And when it comes to applying, the most common piece of advice you hear is apply early. However, merely applying early doesn't tell you when you should turn in each part of your application, nor when you should be working on each section. What does apply early mean for your personal statement? How about the work and activities section or secondary essays? What about recommendation letters? When should those be submitted? If you have these same questions and others, you're not alone. In this video, you'll receive answers to these questions, as well as a specific timeline to follow so you can ensure that you are submitting great materials as early as possible instead of rushing at the last minute. Although a COMAS, the application for DO programs, and TMDSAS, the Texas MD program application, open for submission in early May, and AMCAS, the centralized MD program application, doesn't open for submission until the end of May or the beginning of June, much of your work should be completed months prior. This is because medical schools have a rolling admissions policy, which means if you submit your application earlier, you'll be competing with fewer candidates for a greater number of seats. So here's what you should aim to accomplish between January and April. If your school has a pre-health advising committee, register with them. But note that pre-health committees across schools have different internal deadlines, so you should check in with your pre-health advising office to ensure you don't miss it. They will be responsible for creating and sending a committee letter on your behalf. Meet with your potential recommendation letter writers and tell them your application plans. Provide any resources they'll need to write you a strong letter of recommendation, including your resume or personal statement draft. Prepare for and take your final MCAT. I recommend that your final MCAT be taken no later than in April, so you can dedicate May and June to writing your personal statement, work and activities section, and any other outstanding application materials. Anything later than April, and you'll lose valuable time to write your essays, which will compromise the quality of your application. So brainstorm, outline, and draft your personal statement. If you're applying to MD and DO schools, you may need two different versions of your personal statement. Many students know to draft their personal statement early, but often neglect the work and activities section. Also, brainstorm, outline, and draft this section because it's an incredibly important part of your primary application. In May, ACOMAS and TMDSAS open for submission. In addition, AMCAS opens its demographic and academic sections. You should be dedicating the majority of your time to completing these parts of your application. Too often, students start slow. They get cold feet when their application cycle arrives. But do your best to keep pace with these recommendations so you can take full advantage of rolling admission. Here's what you should aim to accomplish in May. Have your MCAT scores sent to the appropriate application systems. Continue to follow up if your scores aren't reflected in their portals within a week or two. Reach out to your recommendation letter writers and follow up if they haven't already submitted their work. Feel free to nudge them with a gentle reminder. And if they've already submitted their letters, send a nice handwritten thank you note. Order official transcripts from every college and university that you have attended. Yes, this includes community college and study abroad programs. These are used to verify your grades. Finalize your school list. Ensure that you will want to attend these schools, even if they're the only ones you get into. And once you're happy with their quality, submit a COMAS and TMDSAS. Fill out the AMCAS demographic and academic sections. Take some time, especially with the academic sections, as errors in classifying the course type or your grade will delay verification of your application and push it back in the cycle. And if any of the schools you're applying to require it, register for the CASPER test. Once you've completed steps 1 through 7, dedicate the remainder of your time to finalizing your essays. Aim to complete your personal statement and work and activities section by May 15 at the latest. Give yourself some time away from your written materials so you can review them again when AMCAS nears opening for submission. After you finalize your primary applications, begin brainstorming and drafting your secondary essays. When the secondary applications are sent to you mid-June, putting in this early pre-writing work will ensure that your application is one of the first that ADCOM see. AMCAS, ACOMAS, and TMDSAS do not send your primary application to the schools on your list until your essays and official transcripts are in and your transcripts have been verified. Verification usually takes between 1 and 4 weeks, depending on when you submitted your primary application. In early June, when there are few applications ahead of yours, it may take less than a week. But in July, when there are thousands of applications that need to be verified, it can take up to 4. You won't receive secondary applications from schools until your primary application has been verified. Why is it important that your application be verified early? Most medical schools will not review your application until your secondary has also been submitted. This means that your application hinges on the date you submit your secondary, not your primary. A small portion of schools, like various UC schools, will screen your primaries and decide whether to send you a secondary. To make this clear, suppose you submit AMCAS on June 3rd, but do not submit your secondary to the UCLA School of Medicine until August 30th. UCLA will begin reviewing your application sometime after August 30th, when they've already started interviewing candidates. A huge mistake medical school applicants make is to submit their primary applications as early as possible, but they lack considerably when it comes to their secondaries. This is largely due to the overwhelming amount of writing that has to be done during the summer months, plus not understanding the importance of submitting secondaries early. I strongly recommend that you begin pre-writing your secondaries immediately after you complete your primaries. Aim to submit your secondaries as early as possible without sacrificing quality. Submitting in July is ideal, but make sure to do so absolutely no later than August, as this is when most schools will have their interview cycles already underway. By this time, AMCAS will have officially opened, and there's some time between your submission and your application being verified. Use this time to take a short break if you need it, and when you're ready, start getting ahead of the pack by pre-writing your secondaries. Here's what you should aim to accomplish in June. Submit AMCAS as early as possible after it opens for submission without sacrificing quality. If you anxiously submit your essays before they're ready, the low quality will follow you throughout the application cycle. You'll lose the advantage you gain from submitting earlier and harm your overall admissions odds. However, that doesn't mean you should delay submitting due to perfectionism. If you've been working on your application for months and think that your essays accurately capture your personal background and path to medicine, you should prioritize early submission over taking extra days or weeks to make marginal improvements. Make sure that your recommendation letters and transcripts have been received by AMCAS, TMDSAS, and ACOMAS. This means checking your application portals and ensuring that you have received confirmation emails. If they have not been received, check your portal daily and nudge your recommenders to make sure everything is in. You don't want the review of your application to be delayed because of an oversight. Continue pre-writing secondary application essays. Every hour you can get in matters because once you're bombarded with secondaries, they can easily overwhelm you. The number one mistake I've observed at this point in my 15 plus years of guiding students is taking their foot off the gas, since there's no immediate deadline to adhere to. At this point, you'll be in the middle of secondary season, so it's time to put your head down and push through. You've submitted your primary early to receive your secondaries early. Once your secondaries have been submitted, medical schools will have your entire application to evaluate. So here's what you should aim to accomplish in these 2 months. As soon as you receive them, submit your secondary applications without sacrificing quality. Again, balance marginal improvements with submission dates. Once your essays are good enough, submit them. Quick note here, you'll hear that it's ideal to submit your secondaries within 2 weeks of receiving them. While true, it's also true that poorly written essays can hurt your odds of getting an interview. I know I sound like a broken record in stressing high quality essays, but it's critical that you heed this advice rather than submit so-so work ASAP. Getting an early start and pre-writing your essays will help you avoid making difficult decisions later about submitting mediocre applications as soon as possible versus taking a few extra days to improve. And finally, during this time, start preparing for interview season. It will come faster than you imagine. By September, you'll ideally have completed your secondaries. You're now in the middle of a long, anxiety-inducing, yet immensely rewarding interview season. Here's what you should aim to accomplish during these months. Continue preparing for interviews by practicing responses to common questions and getting feedback on your delivery. Once you receive the invite, round out your application with a stellar interview day. If the medical school accepts updates and you have yet to receive an interview from them, send letters of interest if you also have meaningful updates to share, such as a journal publication or a prestigious award. I recommend waiting at least a month after you submit your secondary to give med schools some time to evaluate your application before they read any updates. For schools where you've completed interviews and have been waitlisted, send letters of interest or intent. While both types of letters communicate your fit with a school, a letter of intent also communicates your decision to attend if admitted. A letter of intent therefore carries more weight and should only be written for your genuine top choice. In the fall, if you received an acceptance, congratulations. This is what you've worked hard for years towards, so make sure to celebrate your accomplishment. At the same time, there are a few logistical matters to iron out, and if you've gotten into multiple schools, you have to decide where to enroll. So here's what you should accomplish during these months. Review admission and financial aid offers. Negotiate financial aid offers where you can. If you're in the position to, leverage your other acceptances. If you really want to attend School X, but School Y is offering more money, engage in an honest conversation with School X to see how they can support you better. And now we've come to the final item in our timeline. Make your decision and choose your home for your medical education. By April 30th, you'll have to choose which school to attend and withdraw all your other acceptances. Congratulations, once you're here, you will have really made it. And that's the ideal medical school application timeline. If you found this video helpful, hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed yet, you can do that here so you don't miss out on new videos. If you'd like to learn more, you can also click the link in the description to get a free copy of my ebook, How to Get Into Medical School, which includes an even more detailed timeline, as well as strategies we use to help students get into schools like Johns Hopkins, Mayo, and UCSF. Again, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time.